I thought I knew what the Earth was all about just because I'd looked at it with pictures and video and all these things. And it's like seeing some travel log in some exotic place on Earth and calling that your vacation, right? We do not do that as human beings. We want to physically go to these places because the experience is different. And it's the same thing when you go into space and you look at Earth. You know intellectually what Earth is like from space because we've all seen the pictures, but it's not being there. The human experience aspect of space doesn't come until you can relax a little bit. Now, that happened for me when I was taking my spacesuit off, and I remember floating up to the flight deck, and you look at the overhead windows, and Earth was there, and it was such an intense blue. It was somewhere over the oceans, and it was an intensity of color that no photography, no video, no movie, no film can capture. You can parse more and more details out. When you first look at Earth, you may say, wow, that's a continent. And then you look at it again the next day and you say, wow, there are mountain ranges. And then you look at it again the next day and it's like, oh, I can see synclines and anticlines in the geologic structure. And oh, there's the rain shadow effect, and on and on and on. So the more time you have to look at Earth over a long period of time, the more you can see. So there's more to see in space than just looking at Earth. You look out at the cosmos, and there's many things in the cosmos that are noteworthy to gaze at. And for example, the Magellanic Clouds. Those show up really bright and vivid because you don't have atmospheric scattering. You can see Andromeda. It's a little fuzzy spot on a really, really dark night with good vision. You can faintly make out Andromeda, but in space it just stands out because the contrast is so stark. So there's all kinds of other things to see. There's the moon. It goes through its phases. The angle that the moon makes when it rises relative to your spacecraft changes with time. It's almost like your spacecraft itself becomes a giant astronomical machine, and it's like, okay, the moon was rising over here 2 weeks ago, and now it's rising over there, and why is that? And then you think about the orbital dynamics, where we are in our solar system, this and that, and then it all makes sense. So there's so much to observe, more so than just planet Earth. Yeah, I think it's important to share our experiences with all the people who, as of today, don't have a chance to go into space. But the more people that we can get off of this planet to have these kind of experiences, the more growth you will see in ideas, and the viability of your culture will increase.